Welcome back to Let's Play Stasis Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We just vented the gas from that one corridor so that we can proceed onward to tram station B, I believe. Either way, it's the other tram station, but I want to go look at the monitors here to see what it looks like. Okay, this was the one that had gas and a big skull and crossbones. So at least we see it's at this point at least unoccupied. Kind of worried that now that we've vented the gas, it's supposed to stop any biological life forms from coming in here, although kind of too late because we came across a few of them, right? Or maybe any more biological life forms coming through, but now that we've turned off the gas, anything is just free to come waltzing in, right? Once we open that door, anyway. Hopefully all will turn out all right. So I don't have the hologram anymore. We don't have the pool cue anymore anyway, either. So we're stuck with the same one drill, I think. Override lock and open door. Yes, the gas is gone. And the way is clear. And my mouse decided to cut out on me. I just want to see something. Yep, we still just have the one drill. And I just want to restart my recording because sometimes this messes things up. Okay, finally. Continuing onward. Ooh.
I found her. Your daughter is in the medical bay.
Don't be so sudden with that.
All right, let's do this.
Which is the medical bay? This is forward. Okay, so is the medical bay forward this way, or is it in here? Nothing to look at in here. Either. Nothing here, just a bunch of pipes. Let's just check in here then.
Specimen transport.
This isn't a medical bay, is it? Switchboard. Specimen transport container. Black resin permeates through small perforations in the crate walls. Specimen transport container. A faint scratching noise is coming from the plastic box. Uh-huh. Really? Do I dare?
Project Kitchen Knife.
That's the one we heard about. Project Kitchen Knife. Is that a lock? Is this some kind of lock? Wait. Hold up. What is this? It looks like a lock, doesn't it? Huh. What about this one? Was a PDA there as well?
Limb regeneration.
It looks like you could insert a key, like no, not a key. But obviously, wouldn't even go straight, but like we could hack it, right? Doesn't it look that way? My exit. PDA. No, I thought there was a PDA on top of it. All right, so we've just got the switchboard. Then it's the only thing left. No destination set. Ooh. This opens it, doesn't it? How do I get out? Okay, so it's straight. It goes up a bunch, and then I don't know if I can remember that. like that, isn't it? Somewhat. No destination set. I think that's it. So it comes out, goes down, and then there's a long piece, vertical piece here with like a little, like sideways L. This. Isn't this it? How do I? Do I need to click on anything else after I've set everything? It sounds like it's getting louder. It's lower now. When you go down, it's louder. Maybe after you set it, maybe then you have to go out and mess with it here. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm taking a picture of this. Technically it's cheating, but I'm using my PDA, right? Project Kitchen Knife. God for mobile phones, right? Yeah, this looks like it. Then it comes down. Yeah, this is it. This is the diagram on the side of that. So then what happens here? No destination set. How do I set the destination? Seems like there's something missing from the equation here. Maybe. Second, it might be the last one I have to do. I don't know. I have no clue right now. Should I just try the other one? Or should I now do something here? Press that, no. I mean, I really want to open this with the scratching noise anyway. Let me try this one. I'll take another picture. Alright. Click limb regeneration. Alright. So Should I try with limb regeneration? Maybe I can't get any other one. This looks a lot like it. I think that's it. And then this one, this has the long piece. Goes up. That's that one. Oh, and this is the same, isn't it? That really looks like it. Second back to this?
I don't think this will fit.
Or is my aim to get into the tube and see? Let me just save. I don't want to miss anything that might be optional. So I'm gonna try to go forward here. Funny though, have you see this? We've got security office here, but nothing else has a description. That's strange. Alright, so I got my photos of that, so I can access that.
It's here. Tram isn't operational.
What do you mean? Can you fix it?
No, I don't think so.
There is no other way out of there.
There has to be. Look around.
Fuck, this is all falling apart.
Transport container. Through the tube. I think we are going to be going that way. Cooperation by supporting Kane security officials in a positive manner. Okay. I don't think there's anything positive going on right now, lady. Destroy tram. The gnarled wreckage of twisted steel sits hazardly in wait. Twisted metal. Cops! Roger Callan, quartermaster. Security level 2. Anything else? Over here? Nothing to look at. I got these specimen containers, which I'll look at. What about this body? At least, will they have anything to say? No. Yeah, we can't go further in that direction. A skull and crossbones warning sticker peels up at its edges, indicating that this container was once used to transport dangerous cargo. The sealed lid of the container is caked in a reeking green mold. I wonder if that's where the mold came from, right? The mold started going, destroying their food stores. The plastic container has seen its fair share of use. Alright, let's mess with these.
Medical bay. This is it.
Oh, I want to set it to that. Okay, so I want to take a picture of that. This is how we do things. We don't feel like running back and forth endlessly. Alright, so medical bay.
This one was for hydroponics.
Should I should probably take pictures of all these, right? Why not? It'll be easily be able to tell where each one goes. It looks like we want to go to Med Bay right now, anyway. Because each one's labeled.
Project Seed.
What?
Project Seed.
Nothing, just reading out loud.
She was interested in that. Alright. Alright, so we want to go to Med Bay. Let me find my picture here. I'd say you could never be able to do this back in the day, but this game is only like 2 or 3 years old at this point. 2015, maybe 4 years old. I'm not sure. So anyway, Med Bay, Medical Bay. So he wants to go here, because that's where his daughter is. Interesting that the others don't work. Here we go. Yes. This might be it. No. It looks like it. No, you know what? It comes to like a U shape. Medical Bay, destination set. I got a ride in this thing. Oh, wonderful. Okay. Here we go.
This is either brilliant or very, very stupid.
Both.
I'm gonna say both.
Awesome. I think I like this guy. Wow. That is really eerie.
Quantum devices are not permitted in specimen storage. Quarantine procedures initiated. Quantum storage device reset.
Oh, what? That means you took my drill, damn you.
Okay, let's see what we can see.
That's my drill.
This building looks like the medical facilities. I think I'm on the right track.
Yeah, you're on the medical bay, level one. Your daughter is 4 decks below you.
4 decks?
She is so close, John.
So close.
4 decks. Well, I'm glad I was able to fit in that thing. The infernal glow of these lights is not comforting. Stenciled on one side of this tube are the words specimen receiving. Hanging wires. Due to non-public access, not much care was taken to secure these exposed wires. Oh, so I guess the doctors and the people working here, I don't care about them. Shut down terminals. These terminals control various elements of this apparatus, but every single one of them is dead. This machine may run diagnostics on the specimens that arrive via the tube. So it's also dead. Alright. Nothing else to see here then.
Strange.
Blood?
I'm not breeding any PDTs in your area. They should remain active.
What's that?
Even on the day.
Tell me, John. Why are you working with this jackal?
She's a jackal?
To Milan. She's been talking about me.
PDTs or PDAs?
I'm nobody.
I just want to find my family.
Oh, they're the same thing.
With our family.
Ah.
Alone in that world. The impulse. With the conflict.
Look forward to the beginning of the game.
Are you dead, little John? Make us make no mistake. You are alone.
Oh!
Jim, are you there? I'm jamming from the comm system. What did he say?
He knew me. He knew my name.
Will those things gonna shoot me?
Could he help us?
John, this is happening because of him.
He's not gonna help us,
he
you kidding me?
All of this.
This is all too much for me, too. I'm just a school teacher.
What were those things?
I can promise you that I want to find your family as much as you do. We're in this together.
What were those things? Indentation in the floor. This section of the floor features a rectangular indentation. It's strangely clean in comparison with the other red spattered sections of floor. Okay, so when the blood was coming out, this was open. Not one body can be seen amidst the debris. The crate is locked and not opening anytime soon. So this thing's really gonna kill me. Juca-Cola vending machine. This vending machine has been knocked over, but probably not by an employee. The Kane Corporation certainly didn't subsidize the price of these sodas. Good old Juca-Cola. Banned in several colonies, Juca-Cola is a highly addictive, absurdly potent blast of sugar and stimulants. The cables and wires hang freely from the wall paneling. An engineer's work appears to have been suddenly interrupted. Oh, we got a dead engineer. From these things. There was two of them, though. Where'd the other one come from? Here or over here? Glass door. The view through the sliding glass door is obscured by dried red jets of liquid. Blood, but no bodies. This area has been witness to carnage, yet no bodies litter the ground. Dark blood splatters the walls, but most disturbing is the lack of any cadavers among the gore-soaked carnage. They were either dragged away, eaten, or just pulverized into little bits of dust by these things. I have no inventory. I'm gonna save, because I'm probably gonna die from this. I just want to see what happens, of course. Oh, but look at that! We got a clue, actually. If we activate that one, it'll destroy the other one. Too bad I didn't have the holographic projector anymore. I got a clue for my own death. Don't. Oh. It was right next to you. Why'd you walk over there? Gotta be kidding me. A victim of my own poor pathing. Nope, nope, nope. Juca-Cola. I don't trust him, though. We're gonna throw the... I did not understand a single word of that. Juca-Cola!
Maybe. No.
I don't know what I was thinking there. Never liked your color.
I'm gonna knock. Oh, okay. Okay. The loosely hanging insulated cabling sways gently to a silent tune. Alright, so we've got loose cables.
Maybe. No. It doesn't work like that.
Can't combine.
I think that'll just break it. Nah, that's ridiculous.
Well, what I want to do is attract this thing.
Probably not a good idea.
Saving because pathing. Oh, just push it some more, okay. Are they getting screwed up by this? Is that this? It's saying Juca-Cola, I didn't realize. I thought it was just like more random freaking sounds. Shredded metal tiles reveal a service duct below. So if we can't get through here, which apparently we can't, we can get up through here then, maybe. This great. Now if I just walk over there, it's gonna blast me, isn't it? Too bad I can't grab this. Use it as a weapon. Don't kill me. Hello. Oh, that's me. The inactive gun sleeps silently. Oh. Well, how do I avoid it? There was no safe haven for this poor soul. Sentry gun computer control. This terminal is connected to the turret nearby. A stack of empty Juca-Cola cans sits below. The turret is poised to spring into the room above and eliminate any unauthorized personnel. Slow spinning fan. A sickening odor of death and rot wafts into the room, making you gag from its nauseating scent. Death and rot. So we've got a PDA here, apparently. Slow spinning fan shadow? Really, a description for the shadow. The fan shadow is unnerving, having you nervously checking the periphery of your vision for the movement you swear you saw. The air in the tunnel alternates between stale and putrid with decay. Sounds wonderful. How do I stop this one from shooting me?
That's just crazy. Although... No. Crazy.
Crazy, okay. Maybe it won't attack me.
Found a body too. He's pretty bloodied up.
Steven Dryson. May 18th. More power outages today. Damn it. I thought they had a lid on that. People have been way crankier than usual. One of my boys just broke down today, shaking and scratching like he was suffering from withdrawal or something. I checked with the nurses who examined him, and it seems like there was some sort of drug in his system. He swore blind he wasn't dirty and hadn't been taking anything, but they're already preparing a tribunal for the poor guy. The thing is, I believe him. Everybody's been acting a bit peculiar lately. This one has the dates on top, so I can just advance. November 6th. What's happening to my beautiful ship? That crap is growing up the spine of this baby like a cancer. I keep mailing Dr. Mallon about this. There he is. The one and only. But he hasn't responded to any of my messages. Well, it's funny. He loves talking to me. I know he's reading them because I get more of those stooges from hydroponics down to collect samples whenever I send more than a few words his way. I managed to corner his assistant the other day and demanded to know when we'd be getting our share of the rations. She looked at me like she hadn't slept in a week and said, "Soon." None of us are sleeping properly. I try to greet each day with a smile, but the wrenches are getting panicky, if not mutinous. Wrenches? Or wretches? I spend my time breaking up fights instead of maintaining the engines. I was thinking of taking a group down to the engine ports, and torching that shit off the hull, but I'm worried it's too late for that now. December 20th. No more engineers, no more hope. When you take those things away, you got nothing left. I'm dictating this wedged under the main security terminal. I don't think any of those things will hear me. The rest of the survivors are holed up in the bulkheads, but nobody was willing to risk leaving until we had some sort of protection. I pointed out we'd either starve or die anyway, so they voted overwhelmingly for me to try and get help. So I came down here through one of the maintenance access tunnels and programmed the security terminal to mark any individuals with their PDTs still implanted as hostiles. That should at least get the turrets on our side. I'm not sure it'll work, but it's all I could do. I'm alone now. Hell, I'm used to it. Never met the right girl and all that. I'm pretty sure I heard Lotus screaming, you know. They're probably all dead now, but I can't know for sure. I could hear those things peeling panels off the floor and walls like they were paper. I'll be damned if they find me cowering under the floor like that. Guy Fawkes jumped with a noose around his neck when he was about to be executed. Did you know that? They were going to half-strangle him and then rip him to pieces, but he cheated the executioners, breaking his own neck before they could carry on torturing him. I'm going to do likewise. Got a gun for my protection, see? Only one bullet left, but no matter. I'll only need one. Wow, so I guess that's what happened to him. So, he's... Anyone with PDT still implanted or hostiles, including me, I guess? So if we deprogram the security terminal without that thing attacking me, thinking of throwing the can and making these two turrets take each other out. Although that doesn't have a PDT, it's a can. Oh, there's something else. Notices and reports. Personal data tags from Dr. I. Al Rajkapar to all staff. Personal data tags. Dear all. For those of you who are still able to receive these messages on the intranet, you'll know by now that the creatures are using our PDTs to proceed past security checkpoints. To prevent this, I have decided that each in turn you'll proceed under armed guard to the primary surgery pod, where your PDTs will be removed. Once this is done, they will reprogram the security protocols so that they will target all creatures that still possess these tags. That's very clever. Do not answer the doors to your quarters unless confirmed by the designated password. Today, that word is Aegis. Aegis, okay. So do we need to do this? We need to get our PDTs removed? Apparently so. Emails, inbox and outbox. From S. Dryson to all engineers, read the situation. This is how it is. The unidentified substance is still spreading. It's fouled up engine ports D through G, and after a brief confab with the drive engineers, I can tell you that it's having a detrimental effect on the efficiency and speed of the engines. The long and short of it is that the ship is seriously slowing down. The only thing accelerating is the speed of the fungal growth. Its origin is unknown, although we're narrowing it down. This is a crisis situation. Use the hardest stuff you can find to remove it from the fixtures, and drive plates without actually endangering the protective casing of the drive cores. Good luck, guys. Steve Dryson, Chief Systems Engineer. Remove the fungus from the fixtures and drive plates without endangering the protective casing of the drive cores.